Welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Just exploring the rest of Madhmr Bridge. So we got little sections that we haven't explored. I don't think we're able to see what's here. I couldn't find out how to get in there. Maybe we can get in. No. Yeah, we couldn't get in there, so let's go here. I like to clear out all the fog of war type stuff. You know what? And you know what? I don't want to risk a fight over that stuff. It's not really that useful. It's a bunch of grain and cocoa and stuff. See what's in here, if anything. Oh! A looter! Well, looter. Oh, we still have it. Alright. This is what you get for looting. Hey. Good hit. That was more than one. This guy's running up. Alright, switch everyone back. How tough these guys are, so either way, we'll find out. Just checking. Alright. Should really finish this guy off first. So I'm just gonna run right past you. I'm not sure which one I selected. Amplified thrust off of Eater again. It's basically out of stuff here. Well, we're gonna camp soon. We'll have him run in with melee with this guy, just to distract him. Good, one down. Unfortunately, wasted my amplified thrust. This is gonna bounce off him and get this guy. Everyone else can just wail on this guy. That was easy. A dagger, hatchet, simple clothing, and 5 golden souls. Which means sun. A hunting bow, a club, more simple clothes, lockpicks, and silver louche. The most common Valiant coin found in the Deerwood is the Silver Louche fish, so named for its resemblance to the scales of a fish. Well, that makes sense. Why would they would call it that? That then. Blah, blah, blah. Blood moss. All right, everybody. There's a little more to explore here. Mm-hmm. Interesting. Should we rest?
What?
Yeah, I don't think we're gonna rest just yet.
Yeah.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Oh. I don't suppose he's friendly. Hanwen? Is it possible we could talk to these guys first? I might regret this. Hello? Gathered around the soggy timbers of a ship wreckage, men and women pick through the driftwood, snatching muddy silverware, moldy clothes, chipped pottery, and anything they can spot among the detritus. All eyes turn to you as you approach. The group trade nervous stares at you until at last a woman in muddy clothes steps forward and speaks. "Where are Bertal and Taran?" she asked. "They were just up along that path and we heard fighting." Her eyes narrow and a hand moves toward a knife on her belt as she anticipates your reply. "They attacked us. It was a matter of self-defense." You killed them!" You see Hanwen's eyes rear up before she buries her face in her hands. The men and women around her take a step back, eyeing you cautiously. Hanwen looks up, wiping her eyes. "You speak of self-defense. Well, we are defending ourselves from this storm." Her voice rises and her face grows flushed with emotion. "The floods took our entire farm. We have nothing left. Nothing. No food, no roof, and now I don't even have my cousins." She throws up her hands in despair. "We don't want to fight you. We've lost enough already. Please just leave us." "I came here investigating some missing cargo. We mistook your cousins for looters." "Mistook my butt." She blinks in disbelief. "Looting? But this is a wreck. What value does it have?" The men and women all turn to her, their faces frightened and worried. "Please, we need these supplies dearly. The storm took everything from us. It is not our desire to steal, but we are destitute. Should we let these wares just sink to the river bottom?" Wow. "Regardless of your need, you're still stealing from Paragund. Perhaps you could tell the merchant you found nothing beyond bits of driftwood. From her point of view, it will be as if the river washed it all away. Besides, how much copper will she really make by selling these rotting clothes and soiled wares?" What do you think, guys? You know, if I knew they were telling the truth, I'd be on their side. How do we know they're telling the truth? How do we know they didn't, you know, cause the wreck? I don't know. I will see what I can do. "Thank you," she sighs, whipping sweat from her brow. "You're the first turn of good fortune to come our way in a very long time." Hanwen snaps her fingers at one of her comrades and points to a pile of supplies drying in the sun. "We don't have much, but take this as a token of our thanks." "Really?" We gain an item, Hermit's Hat. Hermit's Hat. Of Might +1. also known as the Curmudgeon's Coif. Hold on a second, guys. Ugh. And the Boiler's Bonner. This cinching chapeau is a tight fit. It was fashioned by an unremarkable wizard who believed the only thing holding him back from a successful career in the arcane arts was his lack of focus and the petty distractions of small-minded types. Infused with misanthropic essence, this has fulfilled his desire twofold. Folk no longer sought out his company, and spellcasting came more easily. Never married, he died alone. This floppy yellow hat sports a wide brim darkened by sweat stains. Oh, beautiful. We'll gladly take that then. Of might plus one is always a good thing.
Yeah?
That's Firebrand. Oh, these people are gone?
Right. Yeah.
The frayed end of the rope drifts in the river. There's nothing in there. Did they mess with us? Hold on, what about this conversation here? A pile of supplies. Where's the pile of supplies? Just a hat? That's a pile? That's what you call a pile? I guess there's nothing else to be done here. I wonder if they really were looters. I wonder if we'll ever find out. Alright, about ready to cross over here.
Looks like we'll be taking the long way to Defiance Bay.
Aerithus. Yep. Yeah, definitely out. Oh, another thing. Reaching out for the soul. You see a battlefield covered with bodies. There is death everywhere. The sound of metal on metal ringing over the gore-stained ground. The cries of the wounded fill the air, occasionally masked by the death knell of another casualty. This man is running, but from what you cannot see. His breath comes in labored gasps. His eyes are wide and terror-filled. As he runs, he wrestles with a blood-spattered tunic. He tears at the fabric as though it burns his skin, his desperation eliciting small mewling sounds from the back of his throat. His foot catches on an arm. Sticking out from a pile of bodies he is trying to maneuver around, and he spills forward, landing on a fallen soldier, looking into his dead eyes. The mewling increases in intensity as he grapples backward, trying to push himself off the body. His hand slips on blood-slicked armor, and he topples to the side, landing on his back. He starts shaking his head, cheeks wet with terrified tears. He pushes himself to his knees and he surveys the field, eyes wide. Breathing so quickly, he's almost hyperventilating. Stumbling back into motion, his hands return to the tunic, eyes swinging wildly about, surveying the carnage around him. His frantic fingers finally tear the tunic from his chest, and he throws it to the ground, the sounds of battle still echoing in his ears as he flees. The man is running, but from what you cannot see, his breath comes in labored gasps. His eyes are wide and terror-filled. Why do I keep saying terror-filled? As he runs, he wrestles with... Wait, I wouldn't know... It's repeating. It repeated it. It's this, and then these two paragraphs. And then this again. Yeah. Madhmr Bridge. Let me just write that down because I'm not sure how to write something like that. Madhmr Bridge. Okay, so we have to continue on, obviously. I can't see heading all the way back to Magrin's Fork. Just to, not Magrin's Fork, Gilded Vale. Just to finish that quest, this guy can wait. I think we have to. We do need to rest also. I have no idea about this Cadnua place. I mean, some people might have mentioned it, but I've forgotten or something. Alright, right here, let me just rest, mostly because we hardly have any spells left here, and he's got nothing, so it's rough out here. Let me just see something. No one else is leveled up, right? Okay. I have to look kind of carefully to see it. Alright. Okay.
Of course.
Oh yeah. No, not just you. Barrier in the way of water here, so we go all the way around that. So I have no idea what this Cadnua place is all about. I don't want to run into those things. Hours, here we go. Yeah, I know. I could use fast mode. I have to get used to this stuff. Is that where we're headed? Hey, Alas, I need her. Dong. Okay. Our man here. Look at that. I'm Batman. What we got? 6 points. He's great with lore, but how about we get a few other things up? Like, survival? We do that. Spells. Okay. It's gonna take a while. Sorry, guys. buffs for our wizard. I can't read all this. Slicken, huh? It's pretty neat. So we can choose either an... We can choose one. Well, obviously we're going to choose a second level spell. Blinding web. Oh, I like that. Corrosive siphon. Okay. It's a vampiric kind of spell. Takes hit points and grants it to the caster. It's like a blindness spell. We got plenty of spells, look at that. I have some potions like that. Ray of Fire. I kind of like this corrosive wounds thing. Causes enemy wounds in the area of effect to ignite, inflicting additional burn damage over time. Each time they are wounded. Oh, great. So they get hit and they get burn damage every time. Five burn damage over time when hit for 26. Okay. Talents, Arcane Veil. That would be helpful. Yeah. You hit someone with your book. Allows the wizard to smash an enemy with a grimoire and energizes spiritual energy, causing large damage, knocking the target back. Grants an extra cast of level 1 spells. Yeah, that's pretty neat. Keeps running out of spells. Yep, we took that. Awesome. Eater. Bong. Alright, so what do you think? Oh, he's got all these spells. I mean, all these points. Athletics is pretty helpful. I really don't have him scout, so... I don't know if we need... I mean... The one that is involved in all these conversations is... our main character, right? Not the NPCs. Take some survival too. Bonus knockdown. I gotta remember to use these. Wary defender. Bloody slaughter. I use him that much as it is. How about Worry Defender? Okay, let me save before I go forward so I'd save all these choices. Oh, did I save? I hit X. Hold on. What the hell am I doing? Cheerful humming, okay, seems alright. Hi.